Be a clown, be a clown, be a clown.
Will you look at this? Saul Burton died.
Who?
Saul Burton, the songwriter. 89 years old, he went just like that from nothing.
Anyway, ABC.
You know what kind of songs he used to write? Shit. Lady, lady, be my baby. Lady, he rhymes with baby. No wonder he's dead.
Put down the grind for 2 seconds. I left 3 clients sitting in my office, so I've come here to see you.
That makes 4 of us out of work.
So how are the children? Since when are you interested in my children? You haven't seen them in over a year. You can't even remember the names.
Millie and Sydney.
Amanda and Michael.
What's the matter? You didn't like Millie and Sydney? I'll tell you what he did. He used to give me the finger.
The what?
The finger. He used to give me the finger. He poked me in the chest with the finger. Do you hear me, doctor? Do you know what I'm saying, doctor? Do you understand, doctor? It hurts to get poked like that, doesn't it?
Yeah.
47 years I got the finger. I got a black and blue hole in my chest. On a dying day, my wife thought it was a tattoo.
Well, what if you wore a padded undershirt?
Don't you think I thought of that? One night I put a steel plate in my chest. He gave me the finger, and he had it in a splint for a month. You want to know other things he used to do? He used to spit in my face. On stage, the man would spit in my face.
Not on purpose.
Not on purpose, he says. If I could have saved the spit, I'd show it to you.
The man would just stand in front of you and spit in your face?
What do you think? He's stupid. He worked it into the act. He would purposely stand with his nose over my nose and only say words that began with a T. Tootsie Roll. Tinkertoy. Typing on the typewriter. Nights I thought I would drown. I don't know where he got it all from. I think he could drink all day
and save it up for the show.
Now he's sitting at home waiting for me to call him to tell him when to come in. And then I have to call ABC and let him know we have a deal. Are you listening to me? ABC's waiting.
What's their rush? What, are they going out of business?
That's it. I'm calling him.
Wait a minute. I don't trust him. He'll rehearse with me all week and then walk out, just like he did the last time, that bastard.
He's not gonna walk out on you.
Last time on the Ed Sullivan Show, he walked out and retired right in the middle of my career.
Man has a right to retire anytime he wants.
Yeah, but I wasn't ready yet. Anyway, he's sick now. You tell me he's got everything wrong with him.
It's ringing.
All right, 60-40. I get 60,000, he gets 40. What the hell can he buy in New Jersey anyway?
It's gonna be all right, Uncle Willie, I promise you.
Tell him I'll do the show, but I'm going to do the show with an against it.
He's got to be home. I told him I'd call him.
Yeah. You know what he's doing? He's practicing spitting.
Hello, Mr. Lewis. It's Ben again. Ben. Ben Clark. Willie Clark's nephew.
He forgot already. He's got arthritis of the head.
It's okay, Mr. Lewis. Willie said yes.
Yes with an against it.
No, he's very anxious.
Who's anxious? Tell him I'm against it, damn you lousy nephew!
What, Monday at 11? What is it, about a 2-hour ride from Jersey?
9 o'clock, make it 9!
No, Mr. Lewis, that's just the television.
Will you shut up?
Okay, you need directions? Listen. This is what you gotta do.
Tell him that if he pokes
you
me,
or he spits at me,
I'm taking him to court.
Right.
Do you hear me? I'm taking him to court. 10 to 20 years for a spit in the face. Tell him, no Tinker Toys, Tootsie Rolls, or typing on the typewriter. You know, Saul Burton died.
Go on. Saul Burton? Who's Saul Burton?
You don't remember Saul Burton?
Oh, the manager of the Belasco Theater.
That was Saul Bernstein.
Not Saul Bernstein. Saul Burton was the manager of the Belasco Theater.
Saul Bernstein was the manager of the Belasco Theater, and it wasn't the Belasco Theater, it was the Marasco Theater.
Sid Weinstein was the manager of the Marasco. Sol Burton, the manager of the Velasco. Sol Bernstein, I don't know who the hell he was.
How can you remember anything if your blood doesn't circulate?
It circulates in my head. It doesn't circulate in my feet.
Anything coming down?
Wait a minute. Wasn't Sol Bernstein that lousy songwriter that wrote Lady, Lady, Be My Baby?
No, for Christ's sakes, that's Sol Burton!
Oh, that's Sol Burton. He died?
Last week.
Where?
In Variety.
Just want you to know that I'm not doing it for the money. I'm giving it all to my grandchildren, Wendy and Mark.
The whole thing?
The whole thing. Not now. Only if I die. If I don't die, it'll be for my old age.
The same with me.
You don't have any grandchildren.
My nephew's children. Raymond and Mervyn. Do you want to rehearse the sketch or not? What?
You're not against rehearsing.
I'm against doing the show. Rehearsing is important.
Okay. Let's move the furniture and make the set.
You're fixing up the set.
I'm fixing up the set.
For the doctor sketch?
Oh, for the doctor sketch.
Smoke?
Look, are we gonna fix up for the sketch, please? My clothes are beginning to stink from this apartment.
If you think you know how to fix the set, you fix the set.
I'd be happy to.
For how much? That's the gypsy chiropractor sketch.
Are you positive?
I'm more than positive, I'm sure.
All right, wise guy. If you think you know how to fix up the sketch, you fix up the sketch.
knock, knock, knock.
Knock, knock, knock.
Don't say it, for Christ's sakes! Do it!
You ready?
I'm ready. Give me a knock, knock, knock. Come in. Come in! Come in already!
I can't. It's stuck.
Oh, for crying out loud. Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
Wait!
Is it stuck?
Not stuck.
Is it locked?
It's not locked. It's locked. I'm locked in. Go downstairs and get somebody. Go tell the idiot. Tell him he'll get somebody.
What?
Go downstairs and get somebody, for God's sakes. Don't you understand English?
Don't yell at me. I'm not the one who locked the door.
Certainly you locked it. Now, why are you standing there wasting time? Go down and get somebody.
It's open. What's the matter with you?
It's open from my side. You locked your... All right, come in already.
Did my daughter call?
You know something? I think you went a little crazy in the country.
Look, are you going to stand there and insult me? Or are we going to rehearse the sketch?
I would love to do both, but we don't have the time. Forget the doll. Just stand there and say knock, knock, knock.
I hope I can get out again.
I hope so too. Knock, knock, knock.
Knock, knock, knock.
Enter!
What do you mean?
Enter!
What happened to come in?
It's the same thing, isn't it? Enter or come in, as long as you're in.
The difference is we've done this act over 11,000 times, and you've always said come in. Why now do you suddenly change it to enter?
I'm trying to freshen up the act.
Oh, well, who asked you to freshen anything up? They asked for the doctor sketch, didn't they? And the doctor sketch starts with come in and not enter. You want to freshen things up, put some flowers in around here.
What's bad about enter instead of come in?
Because it's different, that's why. You know why we've been doing this act for 43 years? Because it's good.
And you know why we don't do it anymore? Because we've been doing it for 43 years.
Well, if we're not doing it anymore, then why are we changing it?
You know what's the matter with you, Lewis? You've been sitting on a New Jersey porch for too long. You don't know what's going on today. From my window, I see everything that goes on in this world. I see old people, young people, good people, bad people. I see drug addicts, car crashes, ambulances, jumpers from buildings. I see it all. You see a lawnmower and the milkman.
That's why you want to say enter instead of come in?
You listening to me, Lewis? Are you listening to me?
I don't see anyone else standing around here.
You don't know what's going on today. Did you ever hear the expression, that's where it's at? Well, this is where it's at, and that's where I am.
Oh, well, did you ever hear that expression, you don't know what the hell you're talking about? It comes right after that other expression. You never knew what the hell you were talking about.
I'm not the one to retire. You're the one to retire because you were tired, because you were old-fashioned. I'm still new-fashioned. I'm still in demand. I'm still hot.
If this room was on fire, you wouldn't be hot.
Look, after you say knock, knock, knocks, I'm going to say enter. If you don't like it, don't come in.
You say enter after I say knock, knock, knock. I'm coming in all right. Only not alone. I'm bringing a lawyer with me.
A lawyer? From where? From New Jersey? You're lucky if a cow comes in with you.
Against you in court, I could win with a cow.
The finger? The finger? You're already starting with the finger?
Nice.
The next time you give me the finger, say goodbye to the finger.
I got a great idea. How about instead of getting together again, we never get together again? You're crazy.
I'm crazy. I'm crazy.
Keep saying it until you believe it.
I may be crazy, but do you know what you are? You're senile. Oh. You know what senile is?
I'm not giving you any straight lines.
Get away. Hello. Who's this?
Is that my daughter?
Will you keep quiet?
Is that my daughter?
Will you shut up? Don't you see me on the phone? Don't you see me talking to a person? For God's sakes, can't you behave like a human being for 5 seconds? For 5 seconds, behave like a human being!
Hello? Just a moment.
It's your daughter.
Sweetheart, I want you to pick me up now. I said pick me up now. Because he's a crazy bedbug, that's why.
I'm a bedbug?
See what I mean?
Your father is sick! Come and get your sick father!
Shut up! Will you behave yourself? For God's sakes, behave yourself!
I told her we'd give it one more shot.
Not if you say enter. Come in, I stay. Enter, I go.
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
Don't do this to me. I have enough pains in my neck. Are you going to say come in, or are you going to say enter?
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
I know you, you bastard.
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
Knock, knock, knock.
Enter!
Crazy bitch!
Enter!
So drop dead in the hallway, crazy
bitch! Enter!
In their first public performance in over 11 years, for half a century known as the Sunshine Boys, Mr. Al Lewis and Mr. Willie Clark, in their beloved scene, The Doctor Will See You Now.
Oh, nursey, nursey.
Did you want me, doctor?
Yes, but we have business first. What's your name again?
Miss McIntosh. Like the apples?
The name I forget, but the apples I remember. Who's my next patient?
Mr. Kornheiser.
Look in the book. You may be wrong. It's better that way.
No, I was right.
So was I.
Excuse me, doctor. You're standing too close.
With you, it's not possible.
Excuse me. I must have a chest cold.
Looks more like an epidemic to me.
Yes, doctor.
Certainly glad I didn't go to law school. Ah, knock, knock, knock. That must be my first patient. Come in. And enter.
I'm here to see the doctor.
Are you sick?
Are you the doctor?
Yes.
Then I think I'm going to be sick.
Sit down. For my records, what's your name?
Kornheiser.
Kornheiser, that's with a K. And your first name?
Wilbur.
Wilbur Kornheiser. Okay, I have to examine you.
No, I have to examine you.
I think you got it all backwards.
It's possible. I got dressed in a hurry this morning.
I'm here to examine you. I'm the doctor.
And I'm here to examine you. I'm the tax collector.
Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle.
We'll discuss your dependents later.
Look, I'm a busy man. If you want to see me, you have to make an appointment with my nurse.
I did. I'm seeing her Friday night.
Don't fool around. nurse. She's a nice girl. She's a Virginian.
A what?
A Virginian. That's where she's from.
Well, she's not going back, I can tell you that. Questions I have to ask you.
If you want to talk to me, you have to be a patient.
But I'm not sick.
That's all right. We'll find something.
Okay. You examine me, and I'll examine you. First question. How much money did you make last year?
Last year, I made...
I didn't hear that.
Ah, hard of hearing. I knew I'd find something. My turn.
Doing?
I'm examining your lower intestines.
Then why do you look in the ear?
If I got a choice of two places to look, I'll pick this one.
Hello.
Obviously didn't pay my electric bill either. Does it hurt you when you get hit like that with a hammer?
Certainly.
Good. Try not to get hit like that with a hammer. Do you see this bottle? Do you know what you're supposed to do in this bottle?
I think so.
You think so or you know so? Tell me, the girl doesn't come in to clean today.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to go in this bottle.
I don't have time. I have to go over your books.
The hell you will.
Listen, if I don't go over your books, the government's going to come in here and go over your books.
Don't they have a place in Washington?
They do, but they have to go where the books are.
The entire government?
No, just the Treasury Department.
Doctor! Doctor!
I told you never to bust in here.
I'm sorry. But Mrs. Kugelman is on the phone and she wants you to rush right over and deliver her baby.
I'm busy. Tell her I'll mail it to her in the morning.
Yes, Doctor.
Where did you find a couple of nurses like that?
She was standing on 43rd and 44th Street. Open your mouth and say ah. Wider! Wider! Aha! Just as I suspected. You got a rotten appendix. I gotta take out your tonsils.
Why the tonsils?
I can't reach your appendix from here.
Never mind my tonsils. What about your taxes?
My what?
Your taxes. To the Treasury. What about your taxes?
I'm warning you. Cut that out. You know what I'm talking about. It's time to pay your taxes to the Treasury. You're speaking with the spitting again.
I read the white line, didn't I? I can't help it if it comes out a little juicy.
Well, stop squeezing the juice. It won't come out that way.
Wait a minute, Mr. Clark. I don't have those lines in my script.
That's because they're not in the script. They're in his mouth. He stopped.
I'm not the one who stopped.
He stopped. I stopped because he's spitting. He's purposely spitting on the T's.
I didn't spit on purpose. I spit on accident. It's not possible to say T's without spitting a little.
Well, don't say T's. Say L's or W's.
There are no L's or W's in taxes.
He just stuck another one in. Did you see it?
Uncle Willie, Mr. Lewis, why don't we just finish the rehearsal and we'll discuss this later.
Hey, do you mind? I'm the director. Why don't we just finish the lines and we'll discuss this later.
Right, fine. But I'm not going to stand here and get a shower in my face.
All right, let's pick it up from the line, I don't know. I hope you don't have a Mr. Melnick at.
Melnick?
Yeah.
Melnick. We're going to pick it up. We're picking it up on Melnick. I hope you don't have what Mr. Melnick had.
What did Mr. Melnick have?
He's right here. Ask him yourself.
Oh,
Mr. Melnick? Could be Mrs. Melnick. Without high heels, I can't tell.
If he's dead, why do you have him standing here?
He still has one more appointment with me.
Do you know what you are?
You're a quack.
Quack! Do you know what a quack is?
A quack is a bastard who pokes me with his finger. He's doing it on purpose. Now the poking. I know his whole routine.
I didn't poke him on purpose. I poked him on accident. It was a tap, a little tap. It wouldn't hurt a baby.
Maybe a baby elephant. I'm not even dry in the face, and he's already starting with the finger.
Hey, who ate all my candy? Did you eat all my candy?
You can't eat it anyway.
Because I ain't quick enough, that's why.
Fastest fingers on the west side. When you're through, I wish you eat the flowers, too. Excuse me, but when you're through gardening, would you mind please taking my pulse?
I took it. It's a little better today.
When did you take my pulse?
While you were sleeping.
Everybody's pulse is better when they're sleeping. You're supposed to take a person's pulse when they're awake.
$75 a day, this one takes a sleeping pulse.
It was a nap, nothing special. How about a little gin rummy, 5 cents a point?
I don't gamble.
If you win, I'll let you eat the cards.
Funny, real funny, Mr. Quap. As soon as I get home, I'll remember to bust out laughing.
They keep sending me any more candy, and you're going to bust out a lot sooner.
You've been trying to get my goat for a week now, haven't you?
If you had a goat, you would have eaten it by now.
You do, and I'll treat you for a concussion.
I'm only kidding. Can't you take a joke?
I can take anything from you because I have a wonderful sense of humor.
If you nurse like your sense of humor, I won't make it to prison. We did? When did you get sick? Hey, what are you doing? Don't fluff up the pillows. It takes me the whole night to get them the way I like them, and then you come and fluff them the hell up.
You keep this up, we're going to have ourselves another heart attack.
We again, my partner.
Stop throwing these papers on the floor. I get paid for nursing, not bending.
Tell me, how old is a woman like you?
It's none of your business.
I'm not asking you for business.
25.
You married?
My husband. He passed away about a year ago.
You were the nurse.
Hey, what are you doing? Don't make up a bed with a person still in it. I'm still sleeping in it.
You tell Mr. Lewis it's okay to come up now? Thanks.
Give him the satisfaction of seeing me sitting in bed like a sick person. I want to sit in my chair.
Uncle Willie, you know the doctor said you're not supposed to get out of bed for anything.
Lewis coming to apologize to Clark is not anything. For me, this is worth another heart attack. Go get my coat. Go get my coat, Ben.
Okay. Just take it easy. What?
I'll get it. All right. And move the chair back, too. Move the chair all the way back. I want that
I'll
son
it.
Of a bitch
I'll do it.
To have a long walk.
He's just coming to say hello. He's not coming to apologize.
He better apologize. If he don't, I'll drop dead in the chair just for spite. Go get the pillows, too, and put them on the chair. I want to look down on that bastard.
Uncle Willie, there's someone here to see you. There's someone here to see you, Willie.
Oh, I don't have my glasses. Who is it?
It's me, Willie. Al.
Al? Al who?
Al Lewis.
Oh, Al Lewis. Al, you're so far away. Come walk on. Walk me out. All the way.
You know, Ernie Eisenstein died?
Go on. Ernie Eisenstein. The house doctor at the palace.
No.
That was Sam Heseltine. Ernie Eisenstein was Ramona and Rodriguez.
Jackie Aronson was Ramona and Rodriguez. Ernie Eisenstein was the house doctor at the palace. Sam Heseltine was Sophie Tucker's agent.
Don't argue with me, I'm sick.
And I should get sick too.
Leave me alone.
Ernie Eisenstein was the house doctor at the palace when we played for the first time with Sophie Tucker. That's when we met Sam Heseltine. Jackie Aronson wasn't even Ramona and Rodriguez yet. He was DeMarco and Lopez. Lopez died and DeMarco went into real estate. That's when Jackie became Rodriguez.
Who the hell cares?
And I'll never forget this.
Forget it, forget it.
Remember Big Al McCaffrey? He owned the Biltmore Theater in Pittsburgh and the Adams Theater in Syracuse. Always wore a 2-pound diamond ring. He said a lot of funny things. Do you want to hear what he said?
Yeah?
Well, do you remember Rosina? He used to hang around with Rosina. And Rosina wore a little black ribbon around her neck because she was skinny. She wanted her cheeks to puff up. She tied it very tight. In fact, she tied it so tight, it affected her hearing. And she couldn't hear the music.